मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम बैक योर इंग्लिश फर्स्ट क्लास. टुडे वी विल लर्न द लेसन, नाइन्थ लेसन, दैट इज मॉडल्स. आई थिंक इट्स फेमिलियर टू यू. मॉडल्स और इट फंक्शंस एज ऑक्सिलरीज, दैट मीन्स अलोंग विद द मेन वर्ब इट मॉडिफाइज अ वर्ब. ओके, already we had learned in future tense will or shall. Okay, these are also included in modals. It has the function of auxiliaries. We will see one by one the modal verbs or modal auxiliaries and its different functions. It's given in the text on page number 56, 57 and 58. Each modals and its functions are given there. Go through it, you will get the use of it. A modal verb is a type of auxiliary verb that is used to indicate modality, that is likelihood, ability, permission or possibility. We used to make sentences in our especially in spoken languages using these modals. For example, will you come, shall we go. Okay, all these are used by using these models. These models help us to indicate likelihood, ability, permission and possibility. They are added to main verbs to express shades of time and mood. For example, they will come. What does it mean? What is the main verb of it? Come. Okay, and this is used along with the main verb to express possibility. Okay, that means they will come, that it indicates time in future. They will come. So that is the use of modal auxiliaries. They do not change their form according to the tenses or the usage, and they will be remaining the same forever. The first type of modal auxiliaries are can or cannot. This is the situation. Pretend you are in an interview. The interviewer asks the interviewee if he has the abilities to do the job. Okay, so what is the response that the interviewer, sorry, interviewee tells to the interviewer, expressing or using can, telling his abilities. He tells that, I can study 3 chapters in an hour. That is my possibility. That is my ability. Okay. He expresses his ability that he can study 3 chapters in an hour. So, can is used to show one's ability. I can sing. I can dance. I can study. I can perform well. All these are used to show our abilities. The second usage of can or cannot is to express possibility. First one is to present ability. Second one is to say one's possibility. I can go there after midnight. That means that is possible for me. I can reach out to the older people. That is my possibility. Okay. I can study up to the maximum level. That is my possibility. So it is also used to show the possibility that one can do. It's also used for asking or giving permissions. Can I take this? Yes, you can. Okay, this is this we use in our daily lives. Can I take this? Can I ask you something? Can I open the door? Okay, all these are asked to request permission. Next one is could. Could is used to ask permission again. Could I borrow your dictionary? That is more polite than using can. Okay, could I borrow your dictionary? Could I get your bicycle for today? Okay, also it is used to request. Could you say it again more slowly? That is an informal way of, sorry, that is more formal way of requesting. again possibility, I think we could have another tea. Future, I wish Kendall could meet me next week. Future, okay. Ability, he gave up his job so he could work for us. That is his ability. Can and could both can be used to express one's abilities, possibilities, permission, request. But when you use could, that is more polite than can. Next model of series, might or may. This is a situation. Pretend one of you is the manager and one is a journalist. The journalist is trying to schedule an interview with a famous rock star managed by the manager. So how he is going to use might or may? Might is used to express possibility. She might be late again today. Okay, so the person who is trying to invite is telling that she might be late again today. This shows possibilities. May is also used to show possibility. He may get promoted next year. That is the possibility. These are the other uses of may. That is asking or giving permission. For example, ma'am, may I go out? Yes, you may. Permission, as a permission she is telling, yes, you may. Also, it is used to express wish. That is, may your trip be pleasant. We always use it, may God bless you. And also it shows express doubt. He may come, although I don't think he will. That is a rare possibility. Okay, express possibility, although I don't think he will. Also, it expresses purpose. The patient may walk again soon. The doctor is telling. Again, express guess. She works hard that she may help her parents. Also, Melba may come early. Shows or guess. Again, using a permission example, may I have another cup of coffee? So the person who listens will be telling, yes, you may have or you may not have. Another usage is possibility. I may finish my homework. Might is used to show possibility. You'd better phone tomorrow. They might be eating their dinner now. Okay, guessing that the situation, someone is telling the possibility that now they cannot make a call because they might be eating their dinner. You might not want to put a band-aid on your cut. You might not want to cover your cut with a band-aid. Okay, see, these are the usages of may and might. Next model is must. Okay, this is used for showing necessity. You must not skip your meals. Okay, this is an essential thing. You must not skip your meals. The other way we have to say, you must eat your meals. This shows necessity to protect your health. This is also used to show inescapable conclusion. The same thing is given in the text as inference or deduction. That was a strong storm. Lives must have been lost. Okay, that means based on the situation, we are making a conclusion that something must have done. Okay, that was a strong storm. Lives must have been lost. Okay, and it was a major accident. So someone must have died. That is my conclusion. Your inference that you make out of a context. Okay, so that these are the usages of must or must not. More examples are given for making a deduction. That is, expresses a deduction about a situation in the present. The beggar has not eaten for 3 days. Deduction, he must be starving. Based on the situation of a beggar, that he has not eaten for 3 days, the person who is there making a conclusion that he must be starving now. Next model auxiliary is shall. Shall is used to make an offer, suggestion, permission. Examples are making offer. Shall I help you with your luggage? Okay. Often we use it. Shall I help you? Shall I ask you something? Okay, that's a offer, suggestion. Shall we say 2:30 then? Okay, if someone is discussing something about a meeting, then we will ask the rest of the people, shall we fix at 2:30? Permission. Shall I do that or will you? But more polite ways to ask could or may than shall. Shall I do that or will you? Shall is more formal than could and may. Should shows obligation. You should not throw away trash on the streets. That's your obligation towards our country. Or you should obey the traffic rules. That is your obligation. This is used to show obligation. Okay, another example is you should clean your scrape with soap and water. You should not touch your scrape with dirty fingers. Okay, it shows probability, obligation, advice. These two are used to give advice. Will is used to, definitely it is used in the future tenses. She will go to Canada next year. That is what is going to happen in the future. Another usage of will is to show willingness. Mark will enlist in the army because the rebels took his family. It shows willingness. Or we will say, when the teacher asks something whether you can do, they will say, I will do it. That you shows your willingness. So this auxiliary is used to show willingness. Another usage of will is to show polite request or refusal. Will you buy me a new shirt? That's a polite use of asking a request. Will you buy me a new shirt? So sometimes it will be refused. So the answer will be no, I will not. Or yes, I will. Would is also used to express a polite request. Would you turn on the air conditioner? Or expresses unreal condition. If I were a judge, I would convict them. That means that is not at all possible. It is never possible in the future. So the person who is telling it, he even may not be a lawyer. So he is telling that if I were a judge, I would convict them. So also used to show polite request or express unreal condition. Would you like some ice cream and apple pie? That is polite request. Next auxiliary or semi-auxiliary is ought to. It shows obligation. You ought to forgive those who have hurt you. It shows strong obligation than must. Okay, you ought to help the needy. That is a strong obligation. It's also used to show necessity. You ought to lock the main gate, otherwise something will happen. Okay, and the example in the text is that is assumption or expectation or probability. They ought to have reached by now, assuming something, because the other person knows the situation. From that he is assuming. Next one is need to. It is used both an auxiliary and an ordinary very. We use need to express necessity. That is auxiliary form. He needn't smoke so much. It's really bad for his health. Again, it shows necessity. We really need to learn another language apart from English. That is a necessity. You need to wait at a red light. Okay, this is used to show necessity. The last one of the auxiliaries, modal auxiliaries, which we have to study in our text is have to. It is used to show again necessity. you have to pay 1000 for the party. This have to we normally use in our daily conversation. You have to come, you have to deal with certain matters, etc. We will use in our daily conversations. So it means the necessity. Children, we wind up the class here. So the modal auxiliaries are used to modify the verb. That it will be placed just before the verb. And whatever the auxiliary we use, after that the verb will be always in verb 1 form, rather than changing its base form. That is, verb 1 only will be used in when you use these auxiliaries, modal auxiliaries. Okay, there are many exercises for you. Almost 9 exercises there in your text. Please do it. After doing, I will send you the answer key. Please submit it after doing. I will send you the answer key after that, so that you will be able to write it correctly. Okay, children. Bye. Thank you.